Hey everyone, hope everyone's having a great Wednesday. And before the video continues, you are definitely going to want to grab your popcorn, your beer, because this is another bombshell video exposing the scumbag, piece of shit, scammer, racist, Christopher Mitchell. Okay? Now, again, I don't know. I got this information passed on last night. I do not know how it slipped through the researcher's hands. I don't know how it slipped through all the numerous people out there trying to dig up stuff. But the fact of the matter is, it was presented to me last night by one of my subs, followers, and it's never too late to continue to get information. I always ask my subs, followers, supporters of the channel, if you think you have any information that I am not privy to or I have not found, please email it to me. If I do have it, I'll simply say I have it. Thanks for the support. And anything you can continue to try to find or want to find on Christopher, please don't be afraid to share. And if you want the email shown, I'll show it. And if you don't want the email shown, I won't show it. So this person had no problems with me giving them a shout out. So again, this is a huge bombshell of a video, okay? Exposing Christopher Mitchell yet again and his lying sack of shit gay porn past. So with that further ado, let's go back and recap everything we've already done numerous times throughout the 2.5 years before we dive into the real show.
One, I hate liars. I absolutely can't stand them. Because one, I hate liars. I absolutely can't stand them. Here, this is my personal Holy Bible. As you can see, it's got my name right there, Christopher Mitchell. And I'll just open it up so you guys can see. So we've got Psalms. I just opened up the Bible. The reason I'm sharing this with you guys is because my wife and I are Christians. We truly do help people. We give a lot of our money to our church and to different charities. And I just want you guys to see, I have my hand on my Bible. And I swear as God is my witness, I've never done gay porn. I've never done any kind of porn. I've never had sex with a man, let alone put it out there on videos.
You ready?
So the hater, Jonas Douchebag, is that what it says? Or Jonas Gorin or whatever. Why did I lie about never doing porn? I never lied, I never did porn. And then delete one of your videos where I lied on the Bible. I've never lied on the Bible. Dude, my Heavenly Father Jesus is so happy with me. I have my hand on my Bible, and I swear as God is my witness, I've never done gay porn. I've never done any kind of porn. I've never had sex with a man, let alone put it out there on video.
Because one, I hate liars. I absolutely can't stand them. Because one, I hate liars. I absolutely can't stand them.
See, entrepreneurs like me, we don't test the waters by putting our toe in it. We just freaking dive in head first and we'll find out if it's cold once we get under the water.
Go look it up. Go look it up for yourself. I've never done porn. Never done gay porn.
You ready?
Doing gay porn. I never did gay porn.
Because one, I hate liars. I absolutely can't stand them.
A hater, Jonas Douchebag, is that what it says? Or Jonas Gorin or whatever. Why did I lie about never doing porn? I never lied. I never did porn. And then delete one of your videos where I lied on the Bible. I've never lied on the Bible. Dude, my Heavenly Father Jesus is so happy with me.
Here.
This is my personal Holy Bible. As you can see, it's got my name right there, Christopher Mitchell. And I'll just open it up so you guys can see.
So we've got Psalms. I just opened up the Bible. The reason I'm sharing this with you guys is because my wife and I are Christians. We truly do help people. We give a lot of our money to our church and to different charities. And I just want you guys to see, I have my hand on my Bible, and I swear as God is my witness, I've never done gay porn. I've never done any kind of porn. I've never had sex with a man, let alone put it out there on video.
Hey everyone, hope everyone had a great weekend and a great beginning of their week. Back again to expose the lying sack of shit, piece of shit, scammer, and horrendous parent, both Christopher Mitchell and Stacy Mitchell are. And as we exposed them numerous times and over the last 2 years, and we continue to reiterate how he swore in the Bible multiple times, saying he's never done gay porn. He's vehemently denied it over and over again, and we've busted him numerous times. And as you can see, here's a screenshot of one of his gay porn movies. And he was, like I said, he was a gay escort prior to this movie, during the movie, and after the movie. All right. And the movie is called College. This is one of the gay porn movies he's done. College Swim Team, No Suits Required. We've posted some of the clips that got taken down by YouTube, and I'd love to do that. Let's just say he had a very, very... very tiny, tiny part in the movie. And I'm not talking role. I'm talking part. All right. And you could say all he wants while the water was cold and whatever. But he was not in the water. He was not in the water multiple times when his tiny part was exposed. Let's just say if anyone has a tiny wee-wee, you too can do gay porn. I didn't think it was possible. I thought all porn movies, porn stars had to have, especially gay porn, a big wee-wee or medium-sized wee-wee. But if you have a small wee-wee, you too can be a gay porn movie maker like Christopher Mitchell. Now, with that said, so again, this doesn't go out to just the new followers, believers, and subs of Christopher Mitchell. This goes out to all my people, all the subs, supporters of my channel, all these years. You guys are now going to be rewarded. This never seen information, all right? So again, I can't thank my subs, my followers, my supporters, anything. Leave it in the comments. You guys can email me at any time. I'm very busy. But again, anytime you want to help or support the channel, please, by all means, send the information. I have the information. I'll simply say I got it. Thank you for your support. Continue to press on and try to find more if you can that I don't have. All right. So with that said, here's the bombshell. We're going to lead into the bombshell. We're going to show some clips. We're going to do the plot line. We're going to do a plot line right up to the very finale. All right. Pick up on everything that's going on.
I was driving down the highway last week, and I started thinking about Mary, and all of a sudden it was like I couldn't breathe. I mean, I felt like I was gonna die.
So I pulled off the road, and I just sort of stopped in this, I guess it was a rest area. I was just kind of shaking, and...
You know, rest areas are homosexual hangouts. Highway rest areas. They're the bathhouses of the 90s for many, 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 many gay men.
That was just a hint to come. We're going to ease into this plot line, okay? The theme of the, pay attention, the theme is truck drivers. Now, for all these years, we thought Christopher Mitchell was targeting the naive. He still is the naive, the gullible, the get-rich-quick seekers, the young kids, the elderly, the foreigners, but now we have the truck drivers. All right, truck drivers. Now, let's get back to when this first originally came out, and we didn't think much of it, you know. The gay truck driver, Bart, who got ripped off and scammed. Let's watch just this really quick clip, and then we'll dive into this more. Keep grabbing that popcorn, chug those beers, because you guys are going to love this.
And he put up in that chat that if you want his new strategy, you got to pay more money. And you just heard him say, all my strategies for one price. So I posted in the group, a guy had a thread saying, how much is it? And I said, I thought we all didn't have to pay any more money once we joined. And Christopher tossed me out the group because I did that one question in there. I'm out of the group now. Do I care? I don't care. But this just tells you what kind of person he is. I've heard people say he gets money from you and he casts you aside. That's exactly what he did.
So again, that was the gay truck driver, Simple Life Bart, who got ripped off and cried about it. Yada, yada, yada. We already went in the story exposing him. Now we are going to touch on this. It was all going to make sense now. Trucker makes $40,000 a year gambling. It was one of Christopher's, another one of his fake testimonials, okay? But why did this guy give a fake testimonial? What did Christopher do to get this guy to give him a fake testimonial? All right, we're going to find that out. Let's roll some clips.
Get off the freeway right now. I'm going to be meeting Jeff in an abandoned parking lot. Literally. I mean, this video is going to be so freaking cool. So I'm super excited. I hope you are too. Let me pay attention to the road. And when I pull into the parking lot and meet Jeff, I'll resume, baby. All right, everybody. This is about to get real. This is Jeff right here in his semi-truck. This is it, baby. All right, everybody.
Hey, how we doing?
Jeff, what's up, brother?
Hey, what's going on, Christopher?
You know, I have never, ever, ever been in a semi-truck in my life.
Hey.
So let's pay close attention to what he just said again. We're going to rewind it. He says he's never been in a pickup truck his entire life.
Hey, how we doing?
Jeff, what's up, brother?
Hey, what's going on, Christopher?
You know, I have never, ever, ever been in a semi-truck in my life.
Hey, I believe it. I never been either until I decided to get into the business.
So, guys, this is Jeff in person.
How we doing?
Man, dude, this is going to be awesome.
Yes.
So, the last video that you and I made, I got a lot of responses. Did you?
Yes. It was flooded.
I think this one is going to be 10 times better. Yeah. It's going to be awesome.
Good.
Man, this is freaking crazy, dude. So check this out, guys. I'm in a semi-truck.
Yep.
For the first time ever.
So we're going to pay attention. We're going to touch on this once again, what he just said. He doubled down saying he's never been in a pickup truck or a semi-truck ever in his life.
Check this out, guys. I'm in a semi-truck.
Yep.
For the first time ever. So let's fast forward. 2017, you started being a trucker.
Mm-hmm.
But 2 years ago, you found me on YouTube.
2 years, yes. I watched you. I know one lady that watched you for 2 years before she just recently joined. And I was about maybe 6 months before I decided to take the plunge and join.
So, he's a trucker, guys, but like a lot of truckers I met, because we've got, I think, like 7 truckers in our group.
Yes.
So, lots of truckers, you know, they're driving.
So, we're going to stop again, make you pay attention to what he just said, that this guy's a trucker, and they have lots of truckers in that group, okay, in his private group of his. They're lonely, some of them are gay, and some of them just want attention, so again, they don't have time to research the web to find out just how much of a scammer Christopher Mitchell is. So again, this is a fake testimonial. This isn't a real one. But again, it's a fake testimonial with a bunch of bullshit, but they do have truckers in that inner circle fraud group. Just keep going.
He's a trucker, guys, but like a lot of truckers I met, because we've got, I think, like 7 truckers in our group.
Yes.
So lots of truckers, you know, they're driving across the country,
casinos all over. Pit stops are in casino parking lots. Mm-hmm. So lots of truckers go to casinos. So he's gambling in between his stops here and there. And did you start that? Actually, you started this because you saw Brandon's video.
Yes.
So,
yes.
My birthday is January 9th. I had a big little powwow in Vegas. Brandon, another member inside my private inner circle, comes up to me. Literally, he comes up to me and says, Christopher, I want to make a video with you. Jeff saw the video of me and Brandon. Mm-hmm.
Well, I'm actually in Crockford's hotel inside of the Resorts World Casino. And I have my buddy Brandon with me. Well, I'm actually in Crockford's hotel inside of the Resorts World Casino, and I have my buddy Brandon with me. Well, I'm actually in Crockford's hotel inside of the Resorts World Casino, and I have my buddy Brandon with me.
I got you, babe. I
And that's when Jeff said, seeing me and Brandon connect in person just like we are, he said, I finally believe that you were real.
Yes. Yes. That this is not made up. That it's not a marketing scheme. This is actually somebody that helped Brandon. And how that video was sincere and not made up, not scripted. Didn't know the questions that were coming to him. Brandon actually had to stop and think. And actually, you had to stop and think about some questions to ask him as well. And
you are full of shit.
You could just tell the mind was rolling. And this is real. This is really real.
You are full of shit.
So that video convinced him that I was real. My tips, my rules, and my strategies were real. And that's what made him say, okay, you know what? Maybe after being a part of Christopher's Inner Circle for 2 years, maybe I should actually start believing in him, implement what he's teaching. And that's when he took a very small, tiny bankroll of only 50 bucks.
Only 50 bucks.
Decided to go online, and in literally in 30 days turned it into $5,000. Yep. And your life has never been the same.
Nope, nope.
You are full of shit.
Hey, how we doing?
Jeff, what's up, brother?
Hey, what's going on, Christopher?
You know, I have never, ever, ever been in a semi truck in my life.
Hey, how we doing?
Jeff, what's up, brother?
Hey, what's going on, Christopher?
You know, I have never, ever, ever been in a semi truck in my life.
Hey, how we doing?
Jeff, what's up, brother?
Hey, what's going on, Christopher?
You know, I have never, ever, ever been in a semi truck in my life.
Hey.
Check this out, guys. I'm in a semi truck.
Yep.
For the first time ever. Check this out, guys. I'm in a semi truck.
Yep.
For the first time ever. Check this out, guys. I'm in a semi truck.
Yep.
For the first time ever.
Because I was driving down the highway last week and I started thinking about Mary, and all of a sudden it was like I couldn't breathe. I mean, I felt like I was gonna die.
So I pulled off the road and I just sort of stopped in this, I guess it was a rest area. I was just kind of shaking. And
you know, rest areas are homosexual hangouts. Highway rest areas. They're the bathhouses of the 90s for many, 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 many gay men.
One, I hate liars. I absolutely can't stand them. Because one, I hate liars. I absolutely can't stand them.
Here. This is my personal Holy Bible. As you can see, it's got my name right there, Christopher Mitchell. And I'll just open it up so you guys can see. So we've got Psalms. I just opened up the Bible. The reason I'm sharing this with you guys is because my wife and I are Christians. We truly do help people. We give a lot of our money to our church and to different charities. And I just want you guys to see, I have my hand on my Bible. And I swear, as God is my witness, I've never done gay porn. I've never done any kind of porn. I've never had sex with a man, let alone put it out there on video.
One time, I wanted to come visit California, and in the middle, from the East Coast to the West, my car broke down, and I didn't have any money, so I decided to hitchhike. So I put my thumb up, and after about 20 minutes, finally, a truck driver came by, and then he stopped, so I jumped in with him and said, hey, where are you going? I said, I'm going out to California. He said, that's where I'm going. Go ahead and jump in. So I jumped in. About an hour later, you know, we stopped, and he got me a bite to eat. And he said, hey, I can take you all the way there, but in order to do so, you got to let me suck your dick. And I said, well, you know, okay, that's not bad, because he picked me up in Texas, so that was just to let him suck my dick, and he was going to take me all the way. So I thought that was a good deal. So we went back in the back of his truck and, you know, sucked my dick and swallowed every bit of it, and it was a good blowjob, and, you know, because of that, I got a free ride all the way to California.
Hey, how we doing?
Jeff, what's up, brother?
Hey, what's going on, Christopher?
You know, I have never, ever, ever been in a semi-truck in my life.
Hey.
Check this out, guys. I'm in a semi-truck.
Yep.
For the first time ever.
One time, I wanted to come visit California, and in the middle, from the East Coast to the West, my car broke down, and I didn't have any money, so I decided to hitchhike. So I put my thumb up, and after about 20 minutes, finally, a truck driver came by, and then he stopped. So I jumped in with him and said, hey, where are you going? I said, I'm going out to California. He said, that's where I'm going. Go ahead and jump in. So I jumped in. About an hour later, you know, we stopped, and he got me a bite to eat. And he said, hey, I can take you all the way there, but in order to do so, you got to let me suck your dick. And I said, well, you know, okay, that's not bad, because he picked me up in Texas, so that was just to let him suck my dick, and he was going to take me all the way. So I thought that was a good deal. So we went back in the back of his truck and, you know, sucked my dick and swallowed every bit of it, and it was a good blowjob, and, you know, because of that, I got a free ride all the way to California.
Because I was driving down the highway last week, and I started thinking about Mary, and all of a sudden it was like I couldn't breathe. I mean, I felt like I was gonna die. So I pulled off the road and I just sort of stopped in this, I guess it was a rest area. I was just kind of shaking and...
You know, rest areas are homosexual hangouts. Highway rest areas. They're the bathhouses of the 90s for many, 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 many gay men.
Wow! Oh, hey, wait your turn!
Hey, and get it. Whoa! Wait a minute.
Hey! No, 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 no. This is a raid!
No! No, 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 I was peeing!
That's what I was doing. I was just peeing.
I was peeing too!
Yeah, I'm sure you're all just pissing. Let's go. Let's move it up. One, I hate liars. I absolutely can't stand them. Because one, I hate liars. I absolutely can't stand them.
Here. This is my personal Holy Bible. As you can see, it's got my name right there, Christopher Mitchell. And I'll just open it up so you guys can see. So we've got Psalms. I just opened up the Bible. The reason I'm sharing this with you guys is because my wife and I are Christians. We truly do help people. We give a lot of our money to our church and to different charities. And I just want you guys to see, I have my hand on my Bible. And I swear, as God is my witness, I've never done gay porn. I've never done any kind of porn. I've never had sex with a man, let alone put it out there on video.
One time, I wanted to come visit California, and in the middle, from the East Coast to the West, my car broke down, and I didn't have any money, so I decided to hitchhike. So I put my thumb up, and after about 20 minutes, finally, a truck driver came by, and then he stopped. So I jumped in with him and said, hey, where are you going? I said, I'm going out to California. He said, that's where I'm going. Go ahead and jump in. So I jumped in. About an hour later, you know, we stopped, and he got me a bite to eat. And he said, hey, I can take you all the way there, but in order to do so, you got to let me suck your dick. And I said, well, you know, okay, that's not bad, because he picked me up in Texas, so that was just to let him suck my dick, and he was going to take me all the way. So I thought that was a good deal. So we went back in the back of his truck and, you know, sucked my dick and swallowed every bit of it, and it was a good blowjob, and, you know, because of that, I got a free ride all the way to California.